Hello React Native developers, I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. In this tutorial, we're going to look at this beautiful heart rate animation inspired from the Apple Watch. We're going to do it using a very simple technique, and then we're going to look at maybe more advanced techniques that can give us a little bit more control over the final result. But let's break down our recipe. So first, we create a loop whose duration is half of the heart duration. When going from 0 to 1, it's only half of the heartbeat. And then we can use it to scale our path. Now we can give it a bit more of an organic effect by adding a fun easing. Easings.net has a comprehensive list of easing functions. And here we can really have fun with it and pick a funky easing function that we can use for our animation. Now we need animation values for the heartbeat waves. We're going to decide upfront the maximum number of waves visible simultaneously on screen. Let's pick 3, which is more than fair. And let's create an index which will point to the next of these 3 values that we will use for the current wave. Every heartbeat, we select one of these 3 animation values thanks to our index reference. We play the animation and increment the index reference. Now let's talk about the styling of our animation. First, we can draw the inner heart and blur it. It gives an impression of a gradient that follows the stroke of the path. And then we can simply blur the heart waves and also play with the opacity to give a nice fading effect. This is our 80-20. This is the 20% of the work that will give us the 80% of the result. After that, we can have a discussion on more advanced techniques we can use that would enable us to finesse the result a little bit more. So let's have a look. We are into VS Code here, and I have a boilerplate project which you can download from the video description in case you want to code along. And so I have my little heart here, which I've drawn and scaled using the fitbox function. And right, so I created a destination rectangle and the source rectangle I get from the compute tight bounds function. So we're going to start by having our heart rate animation value. And I think I'm going to call it progress. And it's a loop, and I have a helper function for this, which is, yeah, just this simple hook, which I use all the time. And so the duration we know is half of the heartbeat duration, which I should have here, right? So I have my beats per minute, so 60 seconds divided by the beats per minute. And here we're going to divide it by 2 because, again, one beat is going to be back and forth. And yeah, let's have a look, and we're going to use it to scale the path. So we're going to use a use derived value. And we're going to return a scale transformation. And we already have the origin of the transformation, which is the center of the canvas, which we have here. We could also take the center of the heart to be more precise. And this is the bounding box of the heart. So we could write center of source also, which is a bit more explicit. But I digress. So the scale, yeah, I mean, here I think the completion was correct. Progress.value, we go from 0 to 1.1 maybe. Let's have a look. No, actually here my origin is not correct. So I was trying to be fancy, but I'm going to take the, oops. And one thing I can do also is to draw an inner heart. So I'm going to create a group here, and I'm going to copy the path, but I'm going to transform it to scale it down, and I'm going to use a different color. So the color 2. And I'm going to scale it to 90%, so 0.9. And here we need the origin, and I'm going to take the center of the path, which I think should be SRC. Yeah, so that looks good. And now what I can do is to blur it, and so it gives an impression of a gradient that follows along the stroke of the path. So I can do a little blur. And maybe 5,
So I think this looks good. So yeah. So you can see here it takes the shape of the heart. You can still see the shape of the heart. So it's like a bit fancier than radial gradient. Yeah. 8 here looks good. And here we can do like a fun easing function. So we have our value here, which I can, and I have an easing function here, beat easing, which I copy pasted from easings.net. So yeah, let's just use that. And I'm gonna need to reload here. So this looks good. We have a nice organic easing effect. Of course, you can use any easing function you want. And the coloring of the heart is somewhat fancy. It feels almost like a gradient that follows the stroke of the path. I like it, and I think now we can look at the heartbeat waves. So we know we want maximum three visible heartbeat waves. So I'm going to create three values. Oops. So values, and I have also another helper for that, use shared values, and I can pass the initial values. And here I want three values, initialize that one. It's just a helper hook I wrote. So we have our values. And we need to create an index. So to remember which value we use of all these three values, which one we use for the next wave. So I'm going to create a ref called index. And we start at 0. Now we need to create an effect. And we're going to create an interval. So set interval on every heartbeat. And we need to clean it when the component unmounts. All right. So here we need to select a value. So we use index.current. We have our value, we animate it. So we set it to 0. So value.value equals 0. We set a timing function. So here the completion is not doing so well. And we're going to do 3 seconds. I think I like it. And then we need to increment. So here the completion is correct. We increment the index, but of course, 0, 1, 2. So we divide modulo 3. So next time we go back to 0. So this actually looks pretty okay. And so let's have a look. So now we have our values. And yeah, this is also okay. We have a beat component, which gets a progress value as property. And let's first use it. So we're going to animate a couple of properties. Let's use it for the transform. Maybe we're going to scale from 1 to 3, 4. I don't know. So let's 1, 2, 3. And it's already, the pivot point is already the center of the Canva. So that looks actually pretty good. We just need to adjust the opacity, the blur, so that at the end it disappears completely. But I think that actually doesn't look too bad. So let's do blur and opacity. So the opacity is simply going to be, we return 1, so the opposite, right? 1 minus progress dot value. So at the end, when we're completed, the opacity is 0. And probably here we want to use some easing. And we can do the blur because we want to be the opacity to go down and accelerate only at the end of the animation. And let's do some blur. So probably we will go, let's say, from, I don't know, 1 to 8. I have no idea. Let's have a look. So this looks good. I can try to accelerate the heartbeat per minute. So I can add, like, let's say 80. So this is 80 now. I think I need to reload. So here we see the waves being visible. So actually here, 3 values is actually not enough. So let's add like maybe a 4th one to see what happens. And I need to update the value count here, 4. Let's have a look. So here, yeah, 120 per. So here, by doing just a little bit of work, we could get to a very decent result. But what if we would want to take it to the next level? I think we would need some sort of a mesh of the heart path, and using the vertices component in React Native Skia, we could really do some fancy shading on the heart and really try to apply more advanced effects. I didn't find any good resources online, or using the Coon Patches component again, because we can do like some color interpolation between cubic Bezier paths. But I didn't find any assets online that would be interesting. But we do have one asset that we can work with, which is a sine distance function of a heart, which is given to us by Inigo Quiles. And we had already a video on the topic. And we already had a video on the topic of sine distance functions. And this is exactly what I have drawn here. So I copy-pasted the sine distance function of a heart. So it looks beautiful. And we can use it to do some shading. So here, if the distance is negative, we are inside the heart. So this is the blue color which I'm displaying here. And we can display so the color of the heart directly. So it's actually C2. And now we can do some shading depending on the distance. The closer we are to zero, we're going to show C2, and the closer we are to the greater the negative distance is from zero, we'll display C1. So we're going to do a mix between C1 and C2. We know the distance is negative here, so I can do absolute value of D. And okay, so I can put, I mean, we're going to change this, but so you see, okay, but we need, so maybe what I can do is, and we need to, let's say maybe saturate, because I'm going to, yeah, let's see. So saturate, and I'm going to maybe multiply by 2. But it's not, so I found one good easing function, which would be the exponent of, yes, I think it should be okay. I mean, I can do C1, C2, something like this, and increase here maybe, or 5, maybe. So here we have some coloring based on the sine distance function. And I'm not sure how you like this version, but the point here is that we do have some control over how we want to control it, because for each pixel, we know the distance from the edge of the heart. And we can do something similar for the waves. So I can set the value here. And so I have these little strokes. But so if we go here, so we have the same shader, but we look at how close we are from the inside, so we have the inside stroke, and the size of the stroke is 0.1, and so that gives us this this level of thickness. And we can also colorize here, and again do a mix of C1, C2, and we don't need to saturate, so we know we have 0.1, so we can just do absolute value of D divided by 0.1. Or I could have, yeah. And I can do C2, C1. So something like this. It's funny, it looks a bit like 3D, right? And I can do opacity and blur. So We can add opacity, which would be the one minus the progress value. So we get it here. And so that's our color. And I can mix it with black based on the opacity value. Something like this, maybe? On minus one minus opacity. Yes. That looks good, and now I can blur. All right, so I think this looks pretty good. The point here is that we really have more control for customizations, and we can also potentially do some blurring based on the sign distance functions, and we can get a bit more fancy. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this example. We've done it using first a very simple technique, and then we looked just for fun at using the sign distance function, which potentially can give us more control over the final result. But you've seen that we don't need to go so crazy. We can just also do it very simply. But with the sign distance function also, we could have like some variable blur depending on how close we are to the edges. So potentially we can have a lot of fun with it. And if we have a proper asset, like a mesh of the heart, we could use a vertices component or the coon patch component to also have like full control over the shading of the heart. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I am looking forward to talk to you soon. And until next time, happy hacking.